blocked. Make that one path.
Fight him off.
Darks.
Magnificent.
Hoping that would be weak to it.
Magnificent.
Interesting, weak to win.
Don't hold back.
That's a nice reach. Dark butterfly. Well, it was AoE. Yes, I was wrong.
Two fight is one.
Magnificent. Not weak. Now these only give up. Not to be.
Magnificent.
Alright, Lati. I'm recharging.
It is your duty.
Well, it has become it. Better spells. Or until someone else gets faster. Why the?
And fight.
Almost. Very cruel. Come on. Okay. You. Time to go inside. Enter Burdenburg.
You reach Burdenburg, a town rife with Laddie's woes. The residents here cannot help but hate those who lay bare their true feelings. As soon as you enter the town, your nose is assailed by a strange odor. It appears a muddy marsh has inundated the place.
Thank you. Thank you for wishing. Ah, okay. Go, go, go.
Destroy.
All out. Maybe not completely.
Teamwork makes the...
Already said that can be used.
You see an old man gulping down the contents of a mud-filled cask. When he notices your party, he suddenly asks, "You youngins up for a challenge?" As if a human could ever compete against me, Lack says. But then, the old man flicks Lack's forehead, sending it soaring.
Well, he didn't stand a chance. On Lattie.
Lattie gets into an awkward fighting stance. Seemingly determined to fight, you'll have to try harder, he says. Suddenly behind her, and claps her on the shoulder.
One remaining.
Don't overdo it, you caution him, well aware of his age. When suddenly, despite his elderly appearance, he moves swiftly. You've got a long way to go, the old man tells you, as he drinks mud from his cask. You did great.
Oh. That's...
Fight him off.
Get more gems.
The bold.
Horror of life.
What should we do today? The man murmurs to himself as he uses mud to craft a human-sized doll. When you ask him what he's doing, he says that he doesn't have any friends, so he's making a mud buddy.
Pristine.
You introduce Lanka to the man, and he extends a mud-caked hand for her to shake. As if I'd let anyone so filthy, it looks like he's out of luck with Lanka. Even so, you see the man's cheeks turn red, as if he's realized something in the process.
Well, he was the one for previous one. Absolutely.
Thinking it might get lonesome with the mud buddy as his the doll begins to wriggle and writhe before transforming into something that looks just like
this is gone with possible the other girl.
Thanks to the mud, he says cheerfully. To your surprise, the residents seem you decide that it may be worth investigating.
No, I'm talking to
you see a girl gleefully playing with the mud. Upon closer inspection, you recognize her as Fila, the Azure Maiden. When you introduce Fila to Lanka, the Ivory Maiden responds sardonically. You seem to be having a lot of fun for a maiden, says the one who looks like she's itching to have a good time, Fila replies playfully. It appears she hit the nail on the head. As Lanka's face reddens. How dare you, the Ivory Maiden shouts, though nothing more makes it out of her mouth. Don't cause trouble. You hear a familiar voice. It sounds like the Azure Attendant. Suddenly, Hyde appears, splashing around in the muddy marsh. Fila and Hyde pay you no mind whatsoever as they frolic in the mud. It appears the volume of mud in the marsh has decreased, perhaps because of all the uses the villagers have found for it. From within the marsh, stairs appear.
Dungeon. Wait, Central Burdenburg is underground. Oh, the large. End of the other stairs. Down. Burdenburg. Indies. And oh yeah, here we go. Achievement unlocked. Live and let live. Where we would have to think to have these. Totally unnecessary. But who's complaining? I am. Okay, I guess. It's always helpful. All the people living in Burdenburg. That's just rude.
Show 'em what you got. You see a little girl drowning in the marsh.
Always his him to do the boss.
Grab a hold, you exclaim, throwing Lack at the poor girl. Lack miraculously lands near the girl, but she doesn't grab onto it. Lack sighs, creating bubbles in the mud, and quietly regrets the hand it's been dealt.
Probably him again.
Lanka reflexively prepares to dive into the marsh to save the girl, but is stopped by Krim. Lanka, you can't swim, she says, exposing the maiden's sole weakness. Lanka decides to leave the rescuing to you, and resigns herself to crouching dejectedly nearby. Without a moment's hesitation, you leap into the marsh to save the girl.
A moment's hesitation, but waited for another to do due to my choice. Try and rescue.
You swim to the girl and grab onto her, but she smiles, as if her drowning had been an act, and praises you. You really are a hero, aren't you? The girl then gets sucked into the marsh and disappears.
Of course, there's a staircase. There's this staircase. Which one do we take first? Oh, this is only a side. Below Burdenberg. Card switch. Which is like that effect. Not in the same place at all. Yeehaw.
Thank you.
Of course. Can we not just automatically level up without the ground? Chop chop. That to happen anytime soon.
Don't hold back.
Or a little. Breathless. Treasure. That looks like Aaron. Had a fight. But yeah.
You see a familiar figure in the center of the marsh. In the depths of the strange mud-filled town, you find yourself. Or rather, a shadow of yourself. As you look closer, you realize that mud oozes forth from his feet. It appears that he is the source of the mud. With an ecstatic expression, he scoops the mud at his feet and calls it talent. The talent for fighting. The talent for making friends. you have used your various talents to lead Laddie on this journey. The shadow points at Laddie and speaks. Talent, yes. Something you lack, he tells her with a haughty laugh.
Laddie's doing her very best.
That's not true, you say. The shadow just laughs and sinks to the bottom of the marsh.
Oh, now the boss is coming. The heart.
So this is the heart scar. Krim gulps as she stands before the horrendous light. Show 'em what you got.
Along with the voice, excise.
A giant shadow emerges from the scar. You stand ready to fight the monster.
Find its weakness. Start with... Heal's probably not gonna work. Not weak. Probably paralysis also going to. Fire is all its weak.
Magnificent.
Ow. Ice is also not it. There is physical. AoE! Bloody hell. I should have saved, shouldn't I? Oh, look at back. Fire damage, it will be.
Fortune favors the bold.
Oh, of course. Power ink. Damage would oh, come on. Now he does so little damage.
Fortune favors the
where is he? That region up. Oh shit. That's what Burst does. That's not gonna help. Gonna kill her. Survive! Oh shit. Ouch indeed. Okay, I will don't need to save you because you don't get any experience. Nice. No news.
Within the shadow's final words, you sense sorrow. Laddie was entrusted with the duty of becoming a maiden. Thanks to her talent, she was loved by all. But it was a false love. No one would truly love someone who was destined to disappear. When people discovered she hadn't the makings of a maiden, they stopped caring for her, and she descended into the darkness of desolation. After defeating the shadow, you use the maiden's relic to heal the heart scar. You successfully restore the town and heal the wound on Laddie's heart. Your mission fulfilled. You decide to return to the world you came from.
Every memory realm. Water now. Round.
It's so good of you to stop by. The man, you give him a reluctant pat on the arm. Your companions looking on with wry amusement. You spy an old man vigorously working out and ask him what he's doing. He tells you he has to work out in order to be able to keep up during playtime with his grandchildren.
I didn't act as well. That goes all my money.
Fila and Hyde look perfectly content as they splash about in the water. Such a sight is no longer possible anywhere but this world.
Oh, right, I still have the Oh, no. May come in handy. Marty, if she ever comes. Bought it. The other one is too expensive to buy for it. Back up. Alter. Yeah, that thing.
With the door opened by the self-proclaimed spirit spell, you leave the heart's domain behind. Upon your return to your original world, Lanka and Krim look weary from their unbelievable experience. Laddie, meanwhile, is fast asleep on the floor again, recovering from her sudden change of heart. Her sleeping face, which you'd seen occasionally at the grotto,
seems to have softened a bit from the anguished way it looked before. Thanks to the Ivory Maiden and her attendant, you've accomplished your mission. You prepare to take them back to the North Isle.
What about the Crimson?
As you make your way ashore, you see an impeccable line of soldiers in white armor awaiting you. A welcome party? Lack asks, though the atmosphere is far from welcoming. In accordance with national decree, we have come to apprehend the rebellious maiden, the soldiers say, pointing countless blades at you. According to the soldiers, allowing the masked soldier to escape in the forest was a huge infraction of national decree. Blanca hangs her head. Apparently, national decrees are matters of utmost importance to maidens. A soldier, who appears to be the squadron's captain, claps Blanca in restraints. The maiden must be educated, the captain says. Dispose of the others, including the attendant.
X. You not have five faulties, or it took her. Silly to me. Of course we don't. Critical hit. Oh, come on. I don't do a crit, you have a crit ring. Make sure it counts. Or make sure it doesn't. Probably have gone with the person with the lowest HP. Silly me.
Defeating the soldiers, according to Krim, the maiden will likely be taken to the Foundation, a school beneath the palace,
to be educated. You begin walking toward the palace in hopes of saving the maiden, dragging along the faint attendant. Lanka, she murmurs. Oh, Lanka. Gazes out over the pristine city. Not the easiest place to explore with some snacks in hand. Too clean, he muses. As you enter the shop, you shake your head no, and the smith looks crestfallen for a moment. He quickly shakes it off, then composes his face into a business-ready smile.
Same sort as the Alabaster City and Burden Team Alma. Maybe it doesn't.
Gate that leads to the foundation, you place your hand on your weapon. According to her, there's a hidden passage leading from the maiden shrine to the foundation.
Time is it now?
Edge of the shrine is an old door. You push open the door and descend the stairs dug into the very earth. The dimly lit passage seems to go on for miles. This place gives me the creeps, says Lack with a shudder. There are no ghosts here, so don't worry, Krim replies, encouraging, though I can't say the same of enemy soldiers, you warn them. Then continue quickly on your way.
This is going to be another dungeon, probably sometime. We'll postpone it till tomorrow. Thank you all for watching, and I'll see you then. This was Phoenix Standards. Don't forget to like, subscribe, follow, etc. on this Twitch channel or YouTube or Twitter round.